गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बी डिस्कस अबाउट द रेस्पिरेशन। इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी आर गोइंग टू बी डिस्कस अबाउट द रेस्पिरेशन एंड हाउ द फूड इज गोइंग टू बी प्रिपेयर्ड एंड हाउ द एनिमल्स इज गोइंग टू बी यूटिलाइज द फूड। एंड इन दिस प्रोसेस वी डिस्कस इन द हाउ द फूड मटेरियल इज दैट टेकन ड्यूरिंग द प्रोसेस ऑफ न्यूट्रीशन एंड यूज इन द सेल टू प्रोवाइड द एनर्जी, बिकॉज those food material we have to take for what? For getting the energy. So this is that process by which we are getting the energy, by the breakdown of food material, and that process of respiration is called the catabolic process, and process of photosynthesis is that anabolic process, and this is the catabolic process. What is the anabolic and what is catabolic process? So in anabolic process, when the small molecule is going to be joined and then formation of larger molecule, that process is called the anabolism, like the photosynthesis. And when that is large molecule in break into the small molecule, that is called the catabolism, like the respiration. Clear? In this process of respiration, glucose is going to be break down into the carbon dioxide and water, and during this process energy is going to be released. That energy is going to be trapped by the process of photosynthesis from the sunlight, and then we get this energy and going to be utilized for the all metabolic processes. And respiration is the vital process of life because it generates the energy to execute the life process. Okay, those energy is going to be generated by the process of respiration. We are going to be used for the different metabolic process, like the excretion, like the transportation, and different processes we are going to be use the energy. And that process of respiration is going to take place inside the cell, so it is called the cellular respiration. So we are going to be define what is the respiration. So catabolic, exothermic, and oxidative breakdown of food to release the energy in the form of ATP. So what is ATP? Adenosine triphosphate. In this form, energy is going to be stored in the cell, and the one molecule of glucose is going to break down and give the 38 molecule of ATP when that aerobic respiration is going to take place. And this is the most important point, and in the exam on marks it is going to be asked what is the respiration. So diverse organism do this in the different way of some use oxygen to break down glucose completely into CO2 and water, and some use this pathway that do not involve the oxygen. Okay, so it some pathway is going to use the oxygen and some not going to use the oxygen. So we are going to be seen here in that it is the very important sketch diagram of whole respiration, and in board exam it is going to be asked in the 3 marks. Some things is going to be missing here in that, and it is asked in the board exam to fill that space. Okay, so glucose is the six carbon molecule, and it is going to be synthesized during the process of photosynthesis, and here in this it is going to break down into the pyruvate, and this is the 3 carbon molecule. So 2 molecule of pyruvate is going to be formed by the breakdown of the glucose molecule. So this process is also called the EMP pathway. Imbedin, Meyerhoff, Parnas, these are the 3 scientists is going to provide this process, that is called the EMP pathway, and that process is going to take place inside the cytoplasm. And for this process no need of oxygen, so without oxygen this process is going to be able to all the organism. So the process of the conversion of glucose into pyruvic acid, that is called the another name is it is called the glycolysis. Okay, that process is also called the glycolysis or EMP pathway. So that process is that takes place inside the cytoplasm of cell. So glycolysis, it means glyco, it means glucose, lysis, it means breakdown. Breakdown of glucose is called the glycolysis. By this process it is going to form the 3 carbon molecule pyruvate, and then it's going the so the different processes when in the yeast it is going to break down into the ethanol, two carbon molecule, and the one carbon is going to be carbon dioxide is going to be formed, and then the energy is going to be released, and that provide the 59 kilocalorie energy is going to be provided by this process, and that process takes place in the absence of oxygen. Clear? It is the first step. When that pyruvate is going to convert the ethanol, carbon dioxide and energy, and this process takes place inside the yeast and absence of oxygen, and that process is called the fermentation. So by which that pyruvate is going to break down, one organic molecule is break down to the another organic molecule, that is called the fermentation. And so that we are going to be seen maximum in the yeast. And so next one, the lack of oxygen in human muscles, and pyruvate is going to convert in the lactic acid. This is the three molecule, carbon molecule. So it is going to be released, the energy 36 kilocalorie energy is going to be released by this process. And next one, this in the presence of oxygen, that process of complete breakdown of glucose into carbon dioxide, water and energy. So in the presence of oxygen inside the mitochondria, complete breakdown of pyruvate is going to take place, and carbon dioxide and water is going to be formed, and during this process the huge amount of energy is going to be released, and from the one glucose molecule 38 ATP is going to be released. It is equal to the 686 kilocalorie energy is going to be released. So 30.5 kilojoule energy is going to release from the one molecule of glucose. So in all the cases of first step is the breakdown of glucose, six carbon molecule into the, there are the carbon molecule called the pyruvate. This process takes place in the cytoplasm of cell, and so this process no need of the energy. So pyruvate may be the converted into the ethanol and carbon dioxide. This process takes place in the yeast during fermentation. And what is fermentation? If the process takes place in the absence of oxygen, is called anaerobic process. So that process that takes place in the prokaryotes, worms, molds, several unicellular eukaryotes is going to be shown the process of anaerobic respiration or the fermentation. So breakdown of pyruvate using the oxygen takes place in mitochondria. So aerobic respiration, the three carbon molecule pyruvate break into the three carbon molecule of carbon dioxide and water is going to be released in the presence of aerobic condition. Okay, in the anaerobic condition, two molecule is going to be formed, that is the ethanol, and in aerobic respiration, the carbon molecule, three carbon molecule pyruvate is converted into three molecule of the carbon dioxide and water. So this process takes place in the presence of oxygen, so it is called the aerobic respiration. Okay, so the respiration is two type. One is that anaerobic respiration, another is that aerobic respiration. If the respiration takes place in the absence of oxygen, it is called the anaerobic respiration, and those process takes place in the presence of oxygen, it is called the aerobic respiration. So in aerobic respiration, complete breakdown of molecule is going to take place, but in anaerobic respiration, incomplete breakdown of glucose is going to take place. So incomplete breakdown, so the less amount of energy is going to be formed during the anaerobic respiration compared to the aerobic respiration. So release of involved of in this aerobic process, a lot of energy is going to be generated. The 38 ATP molecule is going to generate it compared to the anaerobic respiration. Approximately the 2 molecule of ATP is going to be generated by the process of anaerobic respiration.